we just want to thank you, for you are good. We thank you for your unfailing love, for you never change. All your promises in your words are yes and amen. And today, God, in one accord, we are here to honor you, to praise you, to give you glory, God.
that says, comfort, comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to his heart, to the heart of Jerusalem, and cry to her that her time of service and her welfare are ended, warfare are ended, that her punishment is accepted and her iniquity is pardoned, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. Here is the call and the cry of a forerunner. A voice of one, verse 3, who cries, prepare in the wilderness the way of the Lord. Clear away the obstacles. Make straight and smooth in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted and filled up, and every mountain and hill shall be made low, and the crooked and uneven shall be made straight and level, and the rough places a plain. And the glory, majesty, and splendor of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken it. And a voice says, cry, prophesy. And I said, what shall I cry? And the voice answered, proclaim, all flesh is frail as grass, and all that makes it attractive, its kindness, its goodness, its goodwill, and its mercy from God, its glory and comeliness, however good, is transitory like the flower of the field. The grass withers, the flowers fade, when the breath of the Lord blows upon it, and surely all the people are like grass. The grass withers, the flowers fade, but the word of God will stand forever. So Father, we thank you that you are raising up forerunners in this hour. Amen. That you are raising up people who would abide by the standard of God to build a highway, not a low way, not a mediocre way, but a highway for God, a highway of holiness, a highway of lifestyle that breaks through and breaks open every and all kinds of obstacle and clears the way for the coming of the Holy One of God. Jesus is coming soon. Jesus is the message. Jesus is coming soon. Jesus is the message. And how are you going to be in this time, knowing that Jesus is coming quickly? How are we going to live? How are we going to carry on with our lives? How are we going to run with the gospel and the call of God to preach to all the nations, make disciples of nations? What are you going to be? How loud will your mouth be? How quick will your footsteps be in running to those that needs help, that needs compassion, that needs deliverance, that needs to know and walk the highway of righteousness of God? How will you be knowing that Jesus is coming soon? We will run. We will run. We will run into the frontier, into the wilderness, into the places where no one has heard that Jesus is Lord. We will run. We will climb the mountains and shout out on the top of the mountain, Jesus, he is Lord. And let the sound of that proclamation reverberate and resound its sounding. Let it echo all over the earth, the sound, Jesus is coming soon. Let us rise and walk the highways of God, that we may see his face and usher his glory in the midst of the earth. And this is what forerunners for Christ is all about. We attain to that. We contend for that. And we allow God to raise us up in that. In Jesus' name, we thank you, Lord, that we are able, not because of our own strength, but because of what you've done. And we thank you for the past 4 years to which you have allowed us to walk the highways, to walk that place, Lord God, where you are calling us to come and be with you. You're calling us, your invitation to come up here into the heavens, because the door is open and it's wide open, that we may enter, that we may usher in your glory, that your glory may be poured out and flood the earth as your glory covers the earth, the seas, Lord God. Let every heart today be tempered with the knowledge that Jesus is coming soon. That we may not be distracted, but fix our eyes on Jesus, author and finisher of our faith. The Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God. And on that revelation, he will continue to build us up as the church to usher his coming, glorious, without spot, without wrinkle, nor blemish, or any such thing. For we are determined to be a people who would speak of your glory, who would live a life that is pleasing and worthy for you. In Jesus' name. Do you receive this? Say amen.